Wir starten mit dem einzigen tschechischen Teilnehmer, ein Mann, der schon beim World Cup of Darts die Farben seines Landes vertreten hat, ein exzellenter E-Dart-Spieler. Und gestern hat er Diogo Portella, den Brasilianer, aus dem Turnier geworfen. Er läuft tatsächlich ein auf die gute Biene Maja. Evil Charlie, Karel, Sedlacek!
Im bekannten Land, gar nicht allzu lange Zeit. Eine Biene sehr bekannt, von der Sprache alles weit und breit. Und diese Biene, ich meine, nennt sich Maja. Kleine, freche, schlaue Biene Maja. Maja fliegt durch ihre Welt. Das, was ihr gefällt, wir treffen heute unsere Freundin Biene Maja. Die freche Biene Maja.
So, Evil Charlie und die gute Biene Maja. Jetzt muss er ran gegen die aktuelle Nummer 12 der Welt. Der Mann hat 10 Pro-Tour-Siege eingefahren in seiner Karriere. Er hat im vergangenen Jahr seinen ersten European-Tour-Titel holen können bei den Dutch Darts Championship in den Niederlanden. Und er kommt aus Stoke-on-Trent. Ian Diamond White! Fehlen bei Ian Diamond White. Es gilt die Distanz Best of 11 Legs. Man braucht 6 Legs, um in den dritten Tag hineinzukommen in das Achtelfinale. Und auch den Caller wollen wir herzlich begrüßen. You were!
The German Darts Grand Prix second day gets underway with the closest shot of a 48-year-old man from Stoke hitting the dab that you will ever see at a sporting event or indeed anywhere else. Along with whatever the heck that introduction for Karel Sedlacek was. I've no idea, but he seemed to be enjoying himself. It is day two of the third European Tour event of the year. We're here at the Zenith Kulturhalle in Munich. And in this afternoon session alone, we will see 7 previous winners of Euro Tour events. That's before you even get to the evening session with some of the big names, including the 2-time champion of this tournament, Mighty Michael van Gerwen, the world number one. But one of the 7 Euro Tour champions that we see this afternoon is the Diamond Ian White. And he kicks things off. He's the number 2 seed here this weekend. He takes on the Czech, Karel Sedlacek, who won his opening round game yesterday. Diogo Portella was the man he beat, and he was very, very impressive for large portions of that game.
Just I'm like Dan Dawson, that's you where. Game on!
And this alongside me is Rob Malarkey.
Yeah, if you're going to give yourself the nickname Evil Charlie, do not walk on to a bohemian folk song. It just doesn't mix. It doesn't.
You know, I thought that added a sinister edge.
43.
Well, we wonder if Sedlacek will let his darts do the talking today, as he did, as you say, for large chunks of that 100. Match against Diogo Portella yesterday. I spoke to Diogo last night and he was a little bit despondent with how he performed yesterday. He said he was practicing well, he felt good, 59. Felt comfortable on stage, and it just didn't happen for him. But I think in many respects Sedlacek didn't let it happen for Portella, just did not give him a chance in the
97.
First 4 legs, certainly.
Yeah, he was averaging 100 for the first 4 or 5 legs of that game. In the end he won it 6-4. Diogo came back quite strongly, and although the average only finished at 92, if he can replicate the stuff he produced in the
100.
Opening legs, then Ian White could have some problems.
81.
Not the first Czech player to win on the Euro Tour. That was Pavel Jurkl, who won in the opening event of this year. But with us going to the Czech Republic for the first time on the Euro Tour this year. Nice to see some of the talent from that country making their mark. We've got at least one 99. Player from the Czech Republic playing development tour stuff this weekend back in England as well. Roman Benetsky, I believe his name is.
99. Carol, you require 124.
Well, this would be for a break of throw in the very first leg, and that's a lovely first start by Carol. And he's now looking at the bullseye.
99.
And he's 25 away.
You require 100.
So a little scare here for Ian White. That's to switch to the 19, so misses the treble anyway. And so Sedláček will return Kelly looking at 25 this time. His finishing in the first four or five legs yesterday was pretty good too as well. Double eight here.
21.
Well, a couple more misses means that Ian can hold his throw. But it's not been a lightning quick start. Quite the contrast to the game we saw last time from Ian White at this stage when he beat Glenn Durrant on the Euro Tour in an absolute thriller.
Game
there it is.
Ian White.
Gets away with that one, you have to say.
First game on.
But back in business from the word go in leg two. Kicking off with a turn 80.
I do apologise, it was Jamie Hughes he beat, not Glenn Durrant, last time out in the Euro Tour. He ended up losing to Stephen Bunting, the winner of this one.
Hello.
That's on Darren Webster and Nathan Derry, but let's forget about that for a moment because it's a perfect start to this second leg from both men. You've had a feeling, haven't you, in your water?
I have. Not only will we get a nine darter today, I'll tell you exactly which match it will happen in and the outcome of that match itself.
It's not going to be this leg.
It won't be this leg, though.
42.
Nine darters already on the Euro Tour.
I'll leave that one hanging. It's all about the sizzle, not the sausage. Keep the powder dry for a while. Back in business again, said Larchek. One final this year for Ian White.
177.
Piece of set of play as well.
121.
Treble 15. Treble 17 for the bullseye.
83.
And it was a long way off that.
Ian, you require 102.
Well, this leg has been as excellent as the first leg was mediocre. Treble 14 on bull. Oh, stays there for double 11.
80. Cavalier require 38.
Just usher it above those two. Yeah, he did that really well. Used those first two darts to good effect. And he's back on terms at one apiece. Yeah, one final for Ian White this year. Two semi-finals and four quarter-finals on the Pro Tour. April's form in particular has been fairly strong with semi-final defeats by Johnny Clayton and James Wade. No disgrace to lose to James Wade at the moment.
Yeah, and he got close against Wade as well. But, you know, Ian White has been playing at this level for a number of years now. He's one of the best players on the tour. The question is, how many titles can he convert those performances into? So far, he's drawn a blank this year. But last year, won his first big stage title on the European Tour, added a couple of other Pro Tour titles to his collection.
100!
It's only Gerwin Price, Michael van Gerwen and Rob Cross who are averaging more than him in the Players' Championship Series.
Yeah, number one on the order of merit on the Players' Championship last year, £52,500.
140!
10 career ranking titles to his name now, 9 on the Players' Championship, 1 Euro Tour, as he said.
100. Ian, you require 140.
You take a ton here. Made it hard for himself.
100.
Not too hard, though. Typically, Ian White is a guy who'd like to be missing 84. High on the treble and working his way down into 40. It. But twice in the last two legs, he's gone over the top of darts into that treble 20. But the doubles aren't quite there at the minute. 94. Double 6.
88. Ian, you require 5.
Well, a very nervy third leg for these two. Straight towards the double one for Ian White.
No score. Carroll, you require 6.
Well, he pinned double 19. This is just next door. I think he'll go straight at it. Not 2 for double 2. Oh, dear me.
4. Ian, you require 5.
Well, they've both ended up in the madhouse. Ian Weiss is back on 5, though, after busting his score before. And he's there once again.
No score.
Well, 2 darts. Looking at double 1, you cannot miss there. Can't cost yourself that extra dart.
No score. Ian, you require 5.
This is the number 2 seed and one of the best performing players in the world. Has been for the last couple of years, Ian White. And he and Carol Sedlarczyk are having a right old pub game of darts at the minute. This time, the diamond leaves double 2. He won't make that mistake of missing inside and costing himself another dart at double. Oh. Unless he does that!
My word.
Oh!
Carol, you require
silly.
Two.
Well, join
silly
us for
nonsense.
The conclusion of this match sometime around Christmas Eve, I think. 24 darts for White, 21 for Sedlarczyk, and it's 22 darts for Sedlarczyk. And it's a break of throw. Not one that will live in the memory for the right reasons. I think we'll just put that one behind us and move on.
Oh, of course he's going to hit a 180.
140.
Would have been a certain amount of irony had he done so.
60.
Not as busy here at the Zenith as it was last night, but it may well get busier as the day goes on. We do have some incredible games of darts lined up. Daryl Gurney, Kyle Anderson,
can
see a boatload of 180s. Johnny Clayton, Ted Everts next up, which could be a belter. James Wade, one of the four men in darts right now, takes on Kim Huybrex. Aaron Monk's in great form. He's up against Dave Chisnell. All of this afternoon before we even get to tonight when Max Ott, the German number one, kicks things off against Keegan Brown. But we could genuinely see
68.
Michael van Gerwen beaten for the first time in the history of this tournament tonight in the second round because Krzysztof Ratajski, the very dangerous Polish number one,
89,
is pitted against him. And we've got a repeat of the World Youth Final from a fair few years ago when Michael Smith takes on rapid Ricky Evans, who's in the form of his life.
93. Carroll, you require 157.
Well, Ian White has a good opportunity to break back 97. Again here for a
Ian, you require 100.
Two-all scoreline. It's been a bit of a sluggish start, I have to say, in this match to get things started on day two here in Munich.
Should stay on the treble 20 there. Yeah, it was a good lie for it, and he just
60.
Couldn't find his way
Carroll
through.
Carroll, you require 60.
That last start was a bit closer to potentially busting than he might have liked.
Game from the fourth leg.
Well, that'll do for Sedlarczyk. I think it's all about substance over style at the moment for these two, but Sedlarczyk will be delighted with that. Who's this rocker, this aging rocker they keep picking out in the crowd in the front row, by the way?
100.
Is he a local former star of yesteryear? who's fallen on hard times a little
140.
I don't have an answer, Rob. It could be Alexander Oreshkin, for all I know.
I think you're going to say Alexander O'Neill, then.
Well, it might be, but I haven't seen him for a while.
43.
Could be a recurring theme, folks.
100.
One second round appearance, one third round appearance for Ian White so far on the European Tour this year. He was beaten by Stephen Bunting in the last 16 in Hildesheim, although White did miss darts at double 20 to make the score 5-all in that one.
140.
He was building momentum and threatening, but just derailed at the wrong moment in that one. Lost to Justin Pipe, 6-5 in the
85.
Second round in Leverkusen.
Yeah, strange game that one. Justin playing after the recent loss of his father. He said at the end of that one, I think Ian White was thinking about exactly the same things I was and just couldn't raise his game.
140.
Here, it's just been a case of scrappy stuff at the end of legs. Scoring's actually been all right.
82. Ian, you require 78.
Well, so Larchik nearly took out a 94 checkout on the ball earlier in this match. He's warned Ian here. And he gets one dart.
58. Cavalier acquired 94.
Bullseye route again. Double six again.
88.
And he missed it again.
Ian,
yeah, well inside
20.
On that double six again. But he likes that route.
Games from the fifth leg.
Sure, Hugh Ian Ware will be making mental notes about Sedlarczyk's finishing and
game
his
on.
Modus operandi.
Ah, that reminds me, Darren Webster's playing. Nathan Derry on third game in East Anglia Flash.
The tractor derby.
Yeah, those lads no doubt cheering on the diminutive demolition man.
100.
Ian White was a first-time winner on the European Tour last year, one of four first-time European Tour winners. Johnny Clayton, Max Hopp and Gerwyn Price, the others, beating Ricky Evans in the final of the Dutch Darts Championship.
95.
Although his performance in the final itself was perhaps the least impressive of the weekend. Terrific averages against Mervyn King, Adrian Lewis and also Peter Wright over the course of the 3 days there. But it was not quite hitting the heights against Ricky Evans. I suppose it was just maybe a case of the occasion catching up with him, the long day of a final day catching up with him.
129.
But clearly now wants to start going far in TV events. That's the objective for Ian White.
78.
And maybe win one as well one day. Although his latest bid for glory in front of the cameras didn't really end too well. He was beaten in the last 64 of the UK Open, as you alluded to earlier.
120.
Well, good recovery after that disappointing fall out of the board.
No, it's just above it.
43. Ian, you require 57.
So to get back on level terms in this one, the diamond single 17, double top, unobstructed bed.
And
this time he pins it. This is more
Ian
like
White.
It. Ian White with a 14 darter.
Seventh leg, Ian to throw fist. Game on.
Yeah, just a little fist bump there as he made his way back to the hockey. Just trying to G himself up. He was 3-1 down, but he's back on terms at three apiece now, and maybe just maybe starting to find some consistency with his. Well, with his finishing in particular.
100.
I mean, the scoring has been better for Ian White. They both had 180. It's five top 40 plus scores to four. And oh, here we go. And those one treble visits, he's just a shade ahead of Sedlarczyk as well. But they've both missed so many darts at double,
60.
But it's ruined those averages. I say the scoring's been all right.
But that's what's done the damage. Three from 14 plays three from 16.
40. 140.
Just seems to be ticking over a bit more smoothly now, Ian White, as well.
100.
That's more like it. Double 19.
145.
He does get two darts at the double when he returns. Nothing wrong with that as an option.
Yeah, giving himself every possible advantage, Ian White. He's not taking anything for granted because he knows that Sedláček could suddenly find something again, but Ian White is looking at tops once more. Takes a moment. Reassesses for double 10, and he's inside the wire now. Sedláček is looking at the biggest finish of the lot. This would be one heck of a steal, and it ain't going to happen.
Yeah, but Ian White, when he started 96. Breaking down these doubles and missing 10. Inside, it's got very, very messy.
And it's happening again.
Three for double one. We've been here before.
No score.
We've been here before,
Caroline
Ian.
Requires 74.
And he's found the treble as well. So double 16 for Sedláček. Double 8 upstairs.
66.
And he too is inside. Head in hands for the Sedláček support
10.
Crew. They're a fairly effervescent bunch, aren't they?
They
did you
be
see them
themselves this weekend? Well, the diamond just taking a moment. Is he looking at two for double four? He is. Well, after his problems with five and two and double one, oh, well, let's have a go at double two then.
Eight.
Oh, dear me.
This is a real concern now, isn't it?
Eight.
This is a huge concern for Ian White. It was sensible to switch because he's giving himself more options, but if he's not going to hit the doubles anyway, it doesn't really make too much difference. Sedláček himself is having his problems on doubles once again.
Six.
It's becoming a bit
Ian
of an issue, this.
Two.
Both in the madhouse once again.
2,000 people here watching pub darts. Working his way.
No oh. Score.
And again, it's 24 dart legs.
Two.
The story of the day. They're very much on the agenda here.
Games from the seventh.
It's Sedláček who pounces and makes the most of that. And he has the break once again.
Eighth leg, Cavill two.
And we said it yesterday when he had that nervy.
Game on.
Two or three legs against Portela. It was all about coming through the first hurdle, getting the job done, and I think that is going to be the objective here once again.
84.
In the entire, the first 12 events in the Players' Championship Series this year, Ian White has played more than 50 games. He has averaged below 90 once, and that was 89.5 in a game that he actually won. Right now,
139.
Is barely averaging 80.
It's just
baffling. But look, anybody can miss doubles, and anybody can miss whole loads of doubles. But unfortunately for Ian, it's happening now.
100.
And he has done this before, Ian White, when he has on the European Tour, started sluggishly, just
41.
Picked up a little bit of momentum. Although last year he did have an abundance of second or third round defeats, early defeats, losing his opening match. That happened far too many times for a player of his calibre.
98.
Yeah, and yet he went on and won one. He went to the European Championship as one of the top four seeds. It was,
yeah, I mean, he made a semi-final and two quarter-finals as well as that title itself. And in, I think in the bulk of those, he did start off, looking very laboured.
Should stay there.
100.
That's a ton off, and maybe Ian White, if he can go and do his business down this bottom left corner of the board, he's been messing
100.
Up by and large
Ian
when it's, he starts
64.
Missing 20s and 10s. dear. Well, that's 21 off, so that's 43.
And that leaves double 16. So you're right, he's done that. He's gone to that side of the board, 48. But he's inside on double 16 anyway. So it seems wherever he goes, he just cannot find the doubles in the 45. Main with that first arc.
But he's had problems 16. On double 4, a double 2, a double 1. So this double 8 had better go. Oh dear. Oh dear.
14.
Well, my word. The look on the face of Ian White tells its own story. Said Sedláček is looking, well, he's got the 50 off that, so 41 away. Double 16, this will really hurt.
59.
But guess what? He's missed.
Well, it's Ian, the madhouse. Ian White and the madhouse have not had a very healthy relationship so far today.
Certainly one for our number crunchers to look into for the wrong reasons, this one, I think, this opening match.
Surely
of the day.
Surely.
No score.
Wow. This is incredible. I've got to say, I'm Cavalier stunned by this now. It's got to the point where I'm just lost for words in terms of how to explain how this is happening to Ian White, who has been, you know, exemplary on the Pro Tour.
Game
and Sedláček, look at Ian White on his haunches at the back of the stage. I've never seen that from him either. I've never seen that from anybody on the European Tour.
Ian White is in danger of having an absolute breakdown up there. And the opening game of the day, he has been stuck in the madhouse over and over and over again. And it genuinely, there's a reason they call it the madhouse. It is sending Ian White mad.
100.
He has missed 27 darts at double the diamond.
82.
I was just going to say, as is the case in some other sports, if Ian White could have the option now to have some sort of timeout, mind you, I don't think it would do him any good. I think he just wants to... I think he might just be better off just getting back up there straight away and just trying to put things right
100.
Here and now. But I don't know if he's got the opportunity to address this here and now.
45.
I've just had the legend of Dutch darts, that is Jacques Noyelaert, whisper in my ear. He tells me that Ian White's career, the Players' Championship, he wins 70% of his games. The Euro Tour, he wins 50% of his games. But in all his career, there'll be very few games which have been like this.
137.
Where he's just been so consistently stuck on double two and double one, and double five, double anything.
80. Ian, you require 164.
And again, he's so far clear, said Sedláček, in the scoring. Evil Charlie is averaging 78.
60.
And he might be about to knock the number two seed out. He's just mad.
But again, he's potentially going to be ushered back in here. He's, what, 190 adrift minus these.
Ian, you require 104.
And I wouldn't be surprised if Sedláček got darts at a double hit. 86 away. So 61 away for Ian White. Now, which way is he going to go hit?
45.
Yeah. Well, he's looking at treble 15, but the thing is, he's going to come back and he'll go 19 for double top. And yes, he has hit double top and he has hit double 10 in this game. But most of the time he's missing them and then missing everything else.
Surely.
19.
Well, he's throwing the problem is, he is now throwing and just hoping. He has no belief that they're going to go in. And why would you? You've seen what's happened.
It's the Yoko Ono shot done.
58.
Went the right way.
Hope you're watching, Yoko. Don't watch this, though. Because Ian White might miss more doubles.
Games from the ninth leg. Ian White. 10th leg, Carroll, 2, throw first. Game on.
Well, normally you'd say that this is the leg. This is the leg where it should be won and lost because Carroll Sedláček is thrown for the match. But quite frankly, 85. With the way this game has gone, you expect Ian White is going to get darts a double in this leg and the next leg, and there's no guarantee that he wins either of them. Well, he's not going to win the next one if he loses this one, let's put it that way. But it's just an odd game.
And also any clock watchers out there may well be pondering if this could be the longest ever match on the 100. European Tour. It could well be getting very close, especially if we go to a final leg.
30 missed darts at double, three and white. 3-0.
100.
That's a Vidi printer where you'd have to spell it out. Yeah.
IRTY. Brackets.
142.
Well, don't look away now.
The 20 darter actually looks all right. That's actually the median
100
average number of darts in a leg. Ridiculously.
In a sea of mediocrity. And I think these two would admit that as well.
100. Ian, you require 161.
There's very little way to dress this up, I've got to say. Go on, White, take out the 161. Put it all behind us.
102.
Will that
Cavalier
be the last dart that Ian White throws this weekend? Sedláček, 56 away. Tops he wants for the match.
56.
It's another missed dart at a double,
Ian,
and it's a missed
59.
Match dart.
Well, he did hit tops in the last leg, but it took a while. Oh, double 10. Does he believe he can hit this?
39.
It didn't look like it, did it?
Cavalier required
again,
20.
It was more in hope than expectation when he threw that dart, I think.
One of the best players in the world, Ian White, one of the form players, has been broken. He has been broken by double 1 and double 5. And Karol Sedláček is
Good
the first player
the
from
match.
The Czech Republic ever to make the final day of a European Tour. It would not have been in the manner that he wished, but he has done it, and for that, he deserves plenty of credit. Because you've got to hit your doubles to win a game of darts, and there was only one man on that stage who was able to do it. Evil Charlie has knocked out the number 2 seed, and he'll take on either Darren Webster or Nathan Derry for a spot in the quarterfinals. I don't know what that's about or that, but you do what you like. You're the first player for the Czech Republic in the final day of a Euro Tour. Coming up, it's the ferret Johnny Clayton, another former Euro Tour winner, hoping not to suffer the same nightmare that the Diamond has had as he takes on Super Ted Evans.
Großer Moment für ihn. Karel, what a crazy match. Double trouble was in the house.
Double trouble and triple trouble for me now. I played so bad.
But it was the number 12 in the world, so that's a big win for you.
Yeah. I don't know what I say now. I'm very happy, but I think I can play the better darts, and I'm a little bit nervous. Ian White for me is the person, darts person. I don't know what I say now.
Karel, a win is a win. See you tomorrow. Congratulations. Karel Sedláček. Er weiß selbst nicht so genau, was er dazu sagen soll. Er kann eigentlich viel, viel besser Darts spielen. Die sollst du mitnehmen. Und damit steht er also zum ersten Mal in seiner Karriere im Achtelfinale eines European Tour Events. Und dann gibt's Geschenke. Ich hatte mir eigentlich vorgenommen, irgendwie keine blöden Sprüche wegen Ostern. Ei. Was für ein Ding. Da hat sich der Ian mal schön selbst ein Ei ins Nest gelegt. Nein, Glückwunsch.